Hi, welcome back to the virtual training. I wanted to go over a bunch of review for what we are doing this weekend before we drop in to bringing it all together in the physical practice, because we've talked about some of the alignment principles for the body. I'm going to go over them again. And then we're going to talk about the mind-body connection and how important it is for us to tune our mind in this practice as well as our physical body. So the most important thing that we've been working on is finding our pillar and stacking the crown of the head with the heart, with the tailbone, grounding down as we lift up. So we all know that gravity is working really well. That's what holds us here. And then there's also the law of lift and creating this upliftment for the spine. So as much as we press down into our feet, that allows us to lift up. And we're doing that energetically as well as physically. And that law of lift also applies to our mood and our attitude and how we approach our body and approach the swing. So we're gonna bring it all together now for the second half of day two. So I thought it'd be fun to go over these alignment principles both for body and the body-mind connection. I'll put these links in the description. They're Google Docs that you can access that will go over all of these principles in an outline, which is easier to review than to remember. But let's just kind of feel it in our bodies as we talk about it. So one of the things that we've been working on is the loops, working with the spirals, opening up the chest. We just did a whole lot of that. And then we also been working with the spiral with the legs, the internal spiral and external spirals of both the legs and the arms and shoulders. So these loops are incredibly important for getting in tune and in touch with the spirals of the body, the spherical nature, the hubs, the shoulders, the hips. They're a ball and socket. So they don't just move linearly, right? We have to move in all directions and they spin. So a lot of times when I get into the swing and I'm doing this side to side movement, or I'm doing a lot of twists, I'm working with opening up the microcosmic orbit. And that also will lead to working with the toroidal force field and the Merkaba. These are all metaphysics of the body, and it might be new to you. If it is, just stick with me. We're gonna go over this nice and slow, but it's really good to review that and get in tune with the energy body before we go and do the second part where we're connecting all three hollow spheres and working the body together with that awareness of using the breath to move the energy through the body. So we worked with stacking the bones, working with vertical alignment, getting into the hubs, and then we're working with the arch, right? So moving the arch to the upper back so the lower back doesn't get so kinked as well as the neck. Most people tend to arch at the neck and the lower back, and these parts are already curved, and then this will wind up pinching the spine or pinching the nerve there and causing pain. So we want to remember to lift the chest and create the arch from the upper thoracic spine. This will also help us lift the head and get the head into a good position and drop the pelvis. So we're letting the lower body be heavy and weight us down. We're allowing the upper body to have more lift and creating this dynamic tension and tractioning. So even without the swing, we can feel that spaciousness that's happening in the torso. So I think that's all very important to review in terms of the body alignments. And you know, the plumb line, really getting that central pathway, that vertical axis, so important. And that the pelvis is going to be rotating inwards. So I call that spreading the sacrum. So the toes slightly turn in, heels turn out, is going to help with that internal spiral. So I'll keep adding these in the practice, but that's like a quick overview. Now with the mind alignment, I started incorporating this into my practice about 10 years ago, and I really consider the swing to be a vehicle for transformation. It can be that powerful of an empowerment practice for you to get into the swing and use it to redesign not only how you're using your body, but how you're approaching the mind-body connection through exercise. It's so much more to exercise than me, but we want to really be able to work with the physical body get in tune and in touch with the energetic body, which I consider to be the metaphysics, and incorporating the physics of the physical body so that it makes it more fun and easier to leverage our power, get into the free energy, which is the angular momentum, and to find the pivot points so we're using the joints properly and therefore not injuring ourselves. So it's just good to bring it all together. I'm kind of piecing it together one little puzzle piece at a time, and then we'll go back into a practice. So just a few more minutes of talking about this. So how we approach the swing and approach the body is such a huge lesson for how we're moving through the world. So if we can really master this in our bodies and in our minds with something like yoga practice, with something as fun as aerial yoga play and AerialYogaPlay therapeutics, it'll help us move through the world differently. We'll carry ourselves differently, and we'll also approach challenges differently. So if we can come with that playful spirit, that curiosity, and the willingness to explore and experience something new, and we learn that in our bodies, then it tunes our mind to have that kind of eagerness and playfulness when we're approaching challenges and difficulties in our lives. At least that is my prayer and my hope. And it's okay for there to be an off day or to be in a bad mood or something like that. But in general, we want to tune ourselves to focus on the positive aspects and always come to the swing and the practice with an attitude of gratitude for being here, for our bodies, for as much as we can do, and to focus on what we can do. A lot of times when I'm working one-on-one with people or in a teacher training offering this practice, you know, I created it so that we can find a way to get comfortable with the uncomfortable parts of the practice of ourselves. And if we can do that in yoga, if we can breathe into it, if we can approach it with a lighter spirit, you know, with a little bit more humor and playfulness, then it loosens up those ties and those conditionings that we've had in our lives where we're hard on ourselves, where we might be critical or complaining like that we can't do it, or that somehow it triggers the not good enough gene, right? We all fall into that, oh, I'm not doing this right, or I'm not doing this good enough, and comparing. So let's just put all that down and give ourselves a chance to be more compassionate with ourselves when we're learning something new or we're trying something that is beyond our comfort zone, right? So we're actually increasing our upper limit, increasing our ability. It's so good for our brain as we get older to learn something new. And as challenging as that can be, especially if there's an injury or some sort of misalignment, we all have those collection of injuries and asymmetries from life experiences. But if you stick with it and you keep at it with a positive attitude, with a willingness to just keep at it, explore, play, just absolutely do your best and approach your body with a little bit more compassion, it opens up the energy flow. That upliftment of our spirit gets all the kinks out of the energetic straw, because there is a strong mind-body connection that I have seen in my private practice doing healing work for 22 years. And I created this version of the swing and this program to help people heal and to have more fun. Because the healing practice and process can be very arduous and serious for people. And we heal a lot faster when we're actually enjoying ourselves and we're letting the energy flow. So be easy about it. Give yourself a break. Be more playful and lighthearted about it. The idea of changing our approach to the swing to a heart-centered practice and leading from the heart opens up more levels of compassion, understanding, forgiveness, patience, all of those good qualities. But at first, if your heart is feeling tender, if you're feeling a bit of armor around the heart or protected, or your posture for such a long time has been kind of slumped over from working at a computer or sitting too long and those kind of things, let it open slowly. We're not trying to break open this kind of sheath over the body. We're more like water eroding rock. With practice, with time, with consistency, we're removing that surface charge to let things open. And with that said, you might get in tune and in touch with some old emotions that are still sitting there. There's a lot of hurt or a lot of sadness that lives in our chest and affects our lungs, it affects our breathing. Maybe there feels like a disconnect, like you can't really feel your ribs, which happens quite often with my clients. When we start getting into these parts of the body, it's hard to even feel it if they've been numbed out or not plugged in. You know, the circuitry quite isn't there. So that's why I talk about the energy lines of the body. When we plug everything in, when we plug our hips in, when we plug our shoulders in, we can actually start to feel the connection in the body from these different parts. And we've all had some sort of ailment or misalignment over time that might have thrown off the balance between the upper and the lower hubs. So we want to create a symmetry in the body, not only from left to right, but up and down. So that's why I broke it up into these three hubs, the hollow spheres. And there is such a consistent pattern of injury or pain that happens in this upper hub where the neck meets the shoulders, or the lower hub where the lower back and the hips connect. And I work a lot with helping the body heal with technologies, with nutritional healing, with the superfoods and minerals, amino acids, as well as the meditations. And then of course, hands-on manipulation, releasing the soft tissue, as well as getting into some advanced body therapies like quantum healing. So I'm just wanting to inspire and challenge myself to use the swing and show you how I use the swing in these ways that I do in my own personal practice and in my private practice. So that's why this next level iteration of virtual training came about. And I thought it was good to just take the time to go over some of the physical alignment principles, but then get into some of the energetic alignment principles. And we first start with the mind. How are we approaching our body? How are we approaching the swing? If in general you feel low energy or depleted, it's usually because the mind is having some sort of consistent, under the radar, negative thought patterns that start to deplete the system. So it really does work. I know it sounds so cliche, but changing over to an attitude of gratitude, being easy on yourself, and having more of a positive relationship to the body and the swing will really help improve your flexibility and your strength. It's kind of like a straw with a kink in it isn't going to be able to get as much energy flow through it. That's the same with our bodies and our minds. So we're kind of getting the kinks out and first of all, working with the alignment. So now let's go ahead and move into some of the metaphysics of the body. And for me, this is my greatest passion. I've been studying and getting in tune with the energy body for my own healing and personal growth for the last 25 years. But I've also started to incorporate that more into the meditations, more into the language. So the first thing that I like to talk about when we're getting into the energy body is the Merkaba field. And all of this can be researched and looked up online. Drumvalo Melchizedek is one of my favorite teachers with the ancient secrets of the flower of life, but there are tons of teachers out there talking about this double tetrahedron, or sacred geometry of the body. It's even in the Da Vinci Man, you know, like the sacred geometry of the body and the golden ratios, the Fibonacci sequence that pulses through all of nature, like the Nautilus shell. I incorporated those same dimensionalities into the design of the swing. So that's why it fits better than some of the other fabrics and materials and equipment out there. If you have the right dimensions and the right proportions, it'll fit the arms and legs differently. And so we want to work with that. We want to work with how the sacred geometrics of the body affects our health and our strength. So I've always been very athletic in my life, very muscular. And then after a few injuries, I was getting downloaded from spirit to use more of my bones and the energy of the body. And you can find out more about this through Qigong and Tai Chi and things like that. But when I was getting these messages, I had no idea what that meant. I was so used to using my physical muscles for strength. I didn't know how to use the energy of my bones and the energy lines. And I have been studying Chinese medicine and meridians and then yoga, the nadis, and then Thai, the sen lines, and all this stuff for a long time. But I didn't really plug it all in and put it together until I wound up having some injuries where I couldn't use the muscles. It felt like they were unplugged or disconnected. So that's one of the things I like to do when I'm working with someone, is to make sure the circuitry is there and that everything is plugged in. So just scan your own body right now and see if there's anything that feels disconnected, or the circuitry isn't there, or that isn't plugged in fully. And just using your imagination, right? Maybe you don't even know what I mean by that, but intuitively, that part of the body feels like numb or limp or not as strong as the other side, something like that. And some people have a propensity to be stronger in the upper body and weaker in the lower body, or vice versa. Strong in the hips and then weak in the shoulders. There's two pyramids that exist in the body, and I talk about these as portals. There is a base of the pyramid for the sit bones, and that goes up into a point. And then that usually is the feminine pyramid. Women tend to have wider hips. And then there is a pyramid where it goes out at the shoulders, those with really wide shoulders, but seem like their bodies go down into a point. That's usually more of the masculine pyramid. And when we bring these two pyramids together, it creates a star, a double tetrahedron. And this star centers itself in the heart. It's connected to the sacred heart or the soul matrix. And these two geometries actually spin. These two pyramids spin. Now, just like your car, if there's a wobble in the alignment and you're going really fast, that's a problem. So you probably won't go too fast if the tires are off, or you can feel that the alignments are there, like you have a flat tire. So you really want to get the alignment of the body first before the energy body can actually spin, because it's a bigger problem if you're going 100 miles an hour than if you're going 5 miles an hour. So I've noticed that the energetics of the body, the healing of the body, cannot increase until we get these wobbles out. And I represent them as these spheres. If you imagine these balls or balloons in these three areas, and if there's a wobble in one of the areas, it's going to throw off the other two. So that's why I like creating a heart-centered practice where we can focus on getting all of the energies, the heart, mind, body, or hips, all working together, all synchronized and harmonized, and all of this language is infused into my quantum healing meditations now, just to bypass the logical mind and get into more of the intuitive or the energetic body that knows the higher intelligence. You know, the body's intelligent. And we want to get in tune with not only our mind intelligence, but the heart intelligence, and then our gut intelligence, and get them all working together. As a society, we have been tuning and toning our mind, developing our cognitive skills way more than our intuitive skills or our feeling skills, just in general. So then we really want to invite these other aspects, these other energy centers or power centers, to come back online. And I do all that with the swing practice, believe it or not. So even if it just seems like we're doing this pose or doing that pose, underneath it all, that's my intention and that's my focus in terms of weaving together all of the information and turning it into an embodiment practice. So it's more than just physical movement. It is actually connecting the mind, body, spirit, so we can feel the energy flowing. And you don't even need to know all that. If you get out of the swing and you feel lighter and you feel better and you feel more peaceful, then you're there. You don't even have to know what a Merkaba is. But it is fun to know where I'm coming from and how I've gotten to this place of weaving together my whole practice, my physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual practice into the swing. So that's why I call it a vehicle for transformation. So I will, again, share some links in the description for each one of the videos for you to get more acquainted with what a Merkaba field is, how to work with the quantum field, going beyond just the physical body, that we have this energy body around us. I call it the body of light, or this bubble. Some people call it an aura. There's all kinds of different names for it. And then the word holospheres is something that I came up with after working for so long with people in the body, and a lot of people think their body is like flat, like there's the front of the body and then there's the back of the body, and they're not really the same, right? We're working with parts and pieces instead of the whole. So I want to think, I'm encouraging you to think of the band of energy around the body. So if there's something going on with the lower back, it has everything to do with what's happening in the belly. If there's pain in the shoulder blades, it has everything to do with what's happening in the chest. And the same with the neck and the head. If there's a lot of neck and shoulder pain, we have to work on the front body as well and seeing them as bands of energy. And as we go into pulling it all together, I am going to keep reminding you of the different systems, the lymph, endocrine, nervous system, digestion, weaving in all of this functionality into how it's affected by your physical practice. One of the things that I really love doing with the swing is working with the belly, working with the digestion, working with wringing out the organs. Super duper important that we get in touch with this part of our body, because this is the hollow sphere. This is the hub of the hips. And that part can really get disconnected, especially in terms of accessing the emotions that get stored. The emotions that get stored in the tissues, in the fascia, in the lymph, in the surface of the skin, but they also get embedded into the memory of the organs. And so we're wringing all that out. Be really gentle with yourself. If a bunch of stuff comes up after doing the swing, that's part of what people are experiencing when they get woozy or dizzy, is they're having a massive detoxification, a massive cleansing and releasing of all of that stuck energy. And it really is a powerful practice. Just 5 or 10 minutes in the swing and you can have a profound shift. So we're doing a really big deep dive. If at any time the skin gets too tender or sensitive, put on more clothes. If a part of the body just doesn't want more pressure, it will tell you. Let's listen and honor those limitations, knowing if we give it a day or two and come back to it, it's going to respond even better and feel even better. So that's my little spiel about getting into the metaphysics of the body, as well as the mind-body connection and the physical alignment principles. Do check the descriptions and review those docs so you can get better in tune with having an outline that you can print out and even have that by your side. And there are two manuals that go along right now with my practice, the Aerial Yoga Play manual is available and the AerialYogaPlay Therapeutics manual. They're really helpful for reviewing the poses, getting into some principles and variations there. And eventually I will make a third manual that is called the Sacred Geometrics, teaching more of the metaphysics of the body, understanding the physical body, but also these mind-body-spirit connections that we've been talking about. That'll probably be much further down the road, but there is no material yet that has put it all together. That's what I am so excited about in terms of sharing this new virtual training with you. This is pretty much the first time that I am weaving it all together in a way that I'm offering it to the public. People have practiced one-on-one with me, and I talk about these things all the time. But I really love, even if you're a beginner, planting these seeds of understanding the energy body and really getting in tune with this swing practice being so much more than just physical exercise. It really is that powerful. Thank you for listening. I am going to pause so you can just listen to this little verbal review of the physics and metaphysics and alignment, and then I'll be right back to bring it all together for you, and we're going to jump back into the swing and work with the hollow spheres again. Thank you.